Hi there. This time I'd like to introduce you to Alice, my AI assistant I have built on top of OpenAI models. What you can see here is a desktop app that allows me to interact with Alice by simply chatting with her or by using predefined snippets. I have built this app with Tauri framework. So on the front end I have SvelteKit and on the back end is Rust and also Node.js API. The second one acts as long-term memory for Alice because this API is connected to my database. So for example, if I ask her for introducing yourself, she will connect to her long-term memory and answer like this. As you can see here, she knows my name and also is kind of aware of who she is and what she can do. Unfortunately, process of recovering memories and generating responses based on them takes about 15 to 20 seconds. Because of that, I have also a second mode here, which connects directly to OpenAI and works much faster. As a result, I have both access to quick actions and also long-term memory whenever I need. Next, we have a snippet here which may be activated manually like this. But what's more, I can assign them to global shortcuts. So for example, I have caps lock T assigned to translate action. Thanks to that, I can hide Alice and go to any app and then write anything I want, then select it, copy to my clipboard, and press caps lock T to translate this text, which will be available in a second in my clipboard. So basically, in the same way, I can access any snippet I want or even ask Alice for something without activating this app. Now, if you take a closer look at these snippets, you may be thinking how snippets like this one actually works. Well, let's find out. As you can see, I have activated this snippet and also I have a description of one of my tasks. If I send this message, Alice will actually add this task to my list. We have a response here, and after a couple of seconds, a message was replaced with confirmation of adding a task to my list. Now we can go to my Notion and check that this task is actually here. What's more, this task was actually assigned to one of my projects and its priority and deadline was set properly. The reason why it worked is all about this snippet, which were built in a way that Alice has to build a JSON object which will be used as a payload for HTTP request. In this case, this request was sent to the webhook of an automation scenario I have here. As you can see, here is my message, which were processed and added to my Notion. So basically what that means, I can build any snippet I want and then connect it with an external API. And what's more, action like this may be assigned to keyboard shortcut, so I can add a task even directly from my IDE and the confirmation is here. Looks like everything is working and what we have here is a simple API call to OpenAI and also passing of JSON responses, which then I use as payload of HTTP request to my automations. As a result, this simple idea allows me to connect GPT-4 to almost any app or service I may need in my daily life. If you have any question about my project, feel free to leave a comment down below and leave a subscription to my channel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.